Morning, everyone. Today is a very big day for Hong Kong as the city has been holding its breath ahead of its district council election following 5 months of unrest. Starting from 7:30 in the morning today, over 1,000 candidates are going to compete for 452 seats in all 18 districts in the city, with over 4 million eligible voters. And right now, I am on my way to one of over 600 polling stations where Hong Kong's chief executive, Carrie Lam, is going to cast her vote. Because of the traffic control, me and my colleagues have to walk a bit to the polling station. So what does a district council do? It serves as an advisory body for decisions such as building roads and schools and the use of public funds and so on. So district councillors don't have much power, but their seats make up a very big portion, very sizable portion of the committee which selects Hong Kong's chief executive. They also help select the members of the city's legislative council, Hong Kong's legislature. So the district council election is a very important political event in the city. Now, as you can see behind me, this is Raymond College, the place where Hong Kong's chief executive, Carrie Lam, casts her vote. Since she's been in the epicenter of the unrest, which has been lasting for 5 months, this area has been highly guarded by police. And as you can see on the ground, this area with the yellow stripes, this is what they call no staying zone, set up to secure safe and smooth passage of electors into and out of this polling station. Now, only the electors and authorized people can enter polling stations in accordance with the law, but there will be designated areas in the counting stations where the public and the media can observe the process of counting the vote. If everything goes as planned and goes smoothly, the very first election results are likely to come next morning.